Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at animating tables and charts in Keynote. So you can animate between slides and between elements as elements appear on the screen in Keynote. And you could do that with just about anything, including tables. So for instance, I've created a simple table here just by hitting the table button and filling in some sample data. And if I hit play, it'll appear just all at once as you would expect. But we can change how this appears. By selecting the table, which I have already here, I can click Animate here in the toolbar and add an effect. And you can see I'm going to do this on Build In, and I'm going to change how it appears. So I can have it, for instance, to a simple Move In, and you can see it do that. Now the entire table will move in. It'll wait for me to do an action. I'm going to press the space bar and it moves in. So that's a little bit better than just appearing, but we can do even better than that. What would be better is if we had individual elements of the table appear one at a time, and we can animate those. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change the delivery from all at once, and I can do various things. Like for instance, by row, if I were to do that, I can hit the preview button here. You can see I can have each row appear like that, and I can do by each cell, and each one is going to appear. Let's speed things up a little bit. Have it do over half a second, and you can see each cell appears there. And there's a lot of different options of different things that you can do. For instance, you can, a lot of these have reverses. You can do by row content or cell content. So cell content basically says put the chart in there first and then have the contents appear. And I'm doing it in reverse here. What you can do is you can have cells that are grouped together, or you can start at a certain area. So for instance, I can do a delivery by cell and have it build only starting from the fifth one. So it'll do the first four right away, and then I can see each one after that as I press the space bar. I can also decide to change the build order, which means that not only can I move things around, shift things in here so I can have it appear in different ways, but I can group things together and then have them appear, and I can change this B1 to appear immediately after the first build rather than on click. And then I can do that with others, and I could kind of change between on click and after build, and even delay after build. So I can really customize how these things come in to make my presentation exactly like I want it. So you can also do this with charts. I'll click chart here and it'll just create a sample chart for me. And I'll just use this data that's in here. And I also go to animate, add an effect, and add any kind of effect that I want. So for instance, I'll do drift and scale. So you can see how it does that for each one. Let's create something a little more appropriate by using the change button here. And let's do a drop. There we go. So I don't want the entire thing to drop at once, but instead I can go by series, by set, elements in a series, any way I want. So let's do by series, and then we'll preview this, and I'll hit the space bar, and you can see the background drops first, and then that, and then that. And you can do the same thing there with starting the build at a different point or changing the build order if you want to further customize how this looks. So what you might typically want to do very quickly with a table like this is actually change it to by element in the set. So each element is going to be different, and I'm going to have it build, say, from the first, from the eighth to the last. So just the last element there is what's going to animate on the screen. So there I go, and I would be giving my presentation and say, well, guess how sales were in July, and I can have that one drop in, and then the next one drop in like that. You could do these with any kind of chart, although some work better than others. Bar graphs work really good. Pie charts aren't too bad. We've got the ability here to not only have built-ins for these, but also keep in mind you can do built-outs as well. So you can have an effect for it to leave. So you can do move out, and you can do that by wedge. So now we can have it go in piece by piece, and using one effect there, and then when it's time they can all leave piece by piece. So you have that option. You also have actions that you can do in the middle. Like for instance, you can have it do something like a bounce in the middle there. And then, you know, you have a bit of an emphasis here in the middle for anything, for the tables, charts, or any other kind of animation as well, but something else to keep in mind. And of course, when you're done these, if you create something really simple, not only can you use that in a presentation, but you can also export to QuickTime. So if you wanted to create something to enhance a video that you're making, you can use Keynote, create an animated chart, and then export it as QuickTime for little something extra for your videos. Thank you.